Hi guys, welcome back to the web. In this session, I have edited and reduced the noise somewhat. The quality is definitely enhanced and improved. So please just listen carefully as to the material that is being said as our guest speaks about his country, the environmental impact of the economic activity that was taking place, and his culture. Stay tuned, listen through. Hi guys, welcome back to the web. This is my third session with my guest Richie, and we are gonna continue. I'm gonna ask him just one final question on culture, and then we can move on to the economy of his country. So Richie, what is culture to you? What does it mean when somebody says, what's your culture like? Can you explain to our guests?
Culture is a group of people who meet in a particular place to celebrate something and stuff.
So do you believe that your culture is good for you?
The world is changing, so the way my parents looked at our culture will probably be different from the way I'm looking at culture right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm going to ask you basically about your country's growth. Like, what was it like back then, like maybe 10, 15 years ago and now, as it relates to the things that you've seen, the cultural changes in your environment, like more businesses opening up, less businesses opening up, stuff like that. Has your country improved? Has your standard of living improved, in your opinion?
It has. Economically, like, the society, the environment, everything has changed compared to like 20, 30 years ago.
Okay. So I have information from the World Bank, and it says that according to the CEA, environmental degradation costs $6.3 billion annually, or nearly 11% of Ghana's 2017 GDP. Non-renewable resources such as gold and oil cannot sustain growth as resources deplete, while renewable resources like cocoa, timber, and other tree and food crops depend on good environmental stewardship. There are clear signs and scientific evidence that the erosion of the natural capital may put at risk livelihood and human health. So they list air pollution, water pollution, plastic pollution, and e-waste. What have you been observing as it relates to the waste in your country? What have you seen?
I would say that there's a whole lot of pollution here, like human pollution, chemical pollution, a whole lot of pollution. We Ghanaians, we don't use paper stuff, we use rubber, like our careers, our things that we store stuff, they're all rubber stuff. So things that you even package food in, they're all rubber. So recycling it is a bit difficult. And when it comes, like, rubber takes a lot of time for it to get sprouted compared to paper.
You mean
so
plastic?
When it comes to pollution, there. Again?
You mean plastic, right?
Plastic, yeah, like rubber, plastic. Okay. I mean plastic, yeah.
Gotcha.
We have a plastic problem here. And we hardly have, like, companies that can recycle our plastic into other things that they can probably use. So most of the time, it's left, like, unattended, and it's it will be huge somewhere where nobody can do anything about it. And when it comes to this mining, gold mining, people are just doing their own illegal mining, whereby they get to the water bodies that we have in Ghana here, they could spoil it by using chemicals to mix with the and so it would probably spoil the river or the water bodies that we have here, making other villages not to get like clean water to drink, killing fishes, destroying destroying people's form of income and everything. So pollution has a whole lot of disadvantages here in Ghana. We have a whole lot of disadvantages when it comes to pollution.
What about flooding?
Too much rains, landslides, flood.
Too much rains. Come again. I can't understand you.
Flood, like when you have too much water.
Oh yeah. Accra has a lower. Let me say a lower land level. So when it comes to rain, anytime it rains, we get floods here in Accra, but basically Accra, not in anywhere in Ghana, but basically because Accra, we don't have, our lands are high, our lands are low, and most of the places they build, they build buildings on a place where there are gutters or where there are places that water bodies can pass. So anytime it rains, people end up floods everywhere, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But we've never had anything like tsunami where the sea will come, but when it rains, you find people having problems with their buildings, water will come into their house, and the whole it's a whole lot.
Well,
because of how the land is.
According to the World Bank, Ghana loses about 2.7 million meters square of its shore every year, with 80% of the shoreline actively eroding. Coastal erosion and flooding are particularly serious in Greater Accra, where sea level rise increases erosion intensity and raises the chance of flooding by 20%. So you're right, in Accra there is a lot of flooding when it comes to rain. And you know what? For the water pollution causes significant damage equivalent to 3% of GDP. This is due to the health effects of inadequate water supply, poor sanitation and discharge of solid industrial and toxic waste into water systems. Wow. You guys have a lot going on over there.
We have poor sanitation here too. Most of the people they don't really take care of themselves. They end up throwing garbages on this in gutters where it gets choked, you know. People don't really take care of, you know, so we have poor sanitation here too.
So what has the government been doing?
They try to fix it all the time, but they are basically some citizens who try to do the same thing all the time. So you end up being that same problem again.
Mm-hmm. Got you. All right, Richie, thank you so much for tuning in and giving us some of your time. And I'll see you in the next one, okay? Thank you, Richie.